Hey guys, for today's tutorial, we're going to do lofts. To find that tutorial, navigate to the tutorials toolbar menu. To find the lofts tutorial, navigate to all SolidWorks tutorials and lofts. Now in this lesson, we're going to create a hammer head using loft features. A loft is a boss. A loft is a base, boss, or cut created by connecting multiple cross sections or profiles. This lesson demonstrates creating planes, sketching, copying, and pasting the profiles, creating a solid by connecting the profiles, and adding a flex feature to bend the model. So we're gonna click new part, okay, and we're gonna check our planes are showing. Now, planes can be hidden, and often users will like them hidden to keep your viewport nice and clear. That's how I would like to work. To make sure that planes are visible, click on this icon here and scroll down to the planes icon, which is just here. And that shows it enabled, which means if any planes are showing, well, you'd be able to see them. The reason we can't see them at the moment is in the feature tree here, each of these three planes is hidden. Now to show a plane, you can left click on it and click on the show icon, and that will then show you where that plane is in the viewport. So as I rotate around, we can see now the front plane. And we're gonna create a new plane. To do that, we select that front plane as a reference, and then go to reference geometry, plane. We're going to input a dimension of 25 millimeters and press OK. Now, this tool here enables you to place new planes into your model. So those planes can be used for sketches or references, and you can put planes in a lot of different ways, much like you can do sketches, or mates. For instance, they can be parallel, perpendicular, coincident, or set at a dimension. And you can also do multiple planes. So if you want to do multiples at the same distance, you could do it here in one go rather than doing separate plane after plane. We only want one, so we'll press the tick and okay, and we can see it's created there as plane one. The planes used in a loft do not have to be parallel, but they are for this lesson. It's a good point. Now, step two, add another offset plane at a distance of 25 millimeters. Okay, so what we just talked about, with creating that first plane, we could have created multiples. Now we can edit the feature, but when we edit that feature, or once we've created it, we can't go back and then add multiples. It doesn't work that way. So we're gonna do the same step again, put 25 in and press okay, and then hold down control. Okay, another way to create an offset plane is to copy an existing plane. So we're gonna hold the control on the keyboard, select an edge of plane two, drag to a location in front of plane two, and an offset plane, plane three, is created. Okay, to set the offset distance for the plane, type it in and we're gonna put in 40. All right, I don't like that very much, but it's there if you need it. Click okay, your graphics area should look like this image. So we've got the front plane, then plane one, two, and three. We're at this step, we're just gonna save, put that in our folder with the rest of our tutorials. Okay, now sketching the profiles. You create the body of the hammerhead by lofting between simple profile sketches. We're going to select the front plane and click sketch. The view orientation changes to normal two, the front view. There's a note here, you may find it easier to see the sketch entities if the planes are not shaded. You can click options on the toolbar, and on the system options tab, which is here, select display, which is here, and clear display shaded planes and press OK. That is this one here. So if we turn that off and we pressed OK, all those planes would be empty. I'm going to leave it on because I think it'll help in these tutorials. Now we're going to sketch a dimension, 60 millimeters square as shown, and center it about the origin. Now the way they've sketched it with 30 millimeter dimensions is horrible. We're going to use instead a center rectangle, and with that we're going to drop the center point on the origin and drag out. You can see here, when we type in 60, press tab, 60, that sketch is already fully defined. It's added the equal relations. It is centered around the origin and it has the dimension of 60. Much better than what they're telling you to do here. Press the tick to exit the sketch. Now you can see that that sketch there is on the front plane. Next, we're gonna do a sketch on plane one. So we select plane one, press sketch. And we're going to do sketch a circle, also on the origin, with dimension of 50. Press OK. We're going to do a sketch on plane two. This is going to be another circle. Sketch a circle centered on the origin. As you drag, make the diameter of the circle coincident with the vertex of the square. So that's where I drag it and I hover over one of those vertexes and I drop, and it's going to add that relation to make that point of the circle coincident with that point of the square. You can see here our third profile. We've got them on our three planes. Exit the sketch. And the last one, copy a sketch from one plane to another to create another profile. So we go to a 3D view. Now, if a sketch is on the wrong plane, you can change the plane. This is a very useful tool. You right click the sketch in the feature manager and design tree, and you select edit sketch plane, and you can change the plane that that sketch is on. So if we wanted to move it from plane 2 to plane 3, and press here, press OK, and it moves that sketch from one plane to another. This is incredibly useful for moving sketches either to planes or to other faces that you might have created in your geometry. The main thing you need to be aware of is it will your ability to move sketches will be impacted by the order in which you've done them in the feature manager tree and created them on the planes. So for instance, if plane 3 here, if you've done this sketch on plane 2 and then plane 3 was created after sketch 3, okay, if I edit this sketch plane, I can't add it onto that plane number 3 because it's below it in the tree. You need to reorder it before you're able to select it and do it. All right, now let's continue with this section of the tutorial. So select sketch 3, the largest circle. Click copy on the standard toolbar. Okay, you can see I never have that there, but it's there now. Select plane 3 and click paste. Wow, you can tell I've really used these buttons. Hey, paste, brilliant. Copy and paste. I have never heard of them in my life, but I'm going to customize my toolbar, drag them here, and I'll show you how to customize your toolbar in another tutorial. Copy, paste, shoosh, okay. And then this standard toolbar, standard, close that. The one issue I would say though, is that sketch 4 is copied, but there's no relations. So there's no diameter, and there's no relation to the origin. So if we want to truly copy it, it will be good to select that sketch, hold control, select the reference sketch, and make them co-radial. Now it'll be fully defined, and it will follow the position of that sketch that's on plane 2. Save. Creating the loft. This is the fun part. So now use the lofted boss baits feature to create a solid model based on the profiles. Before I do this, I'm going to hide the planes just to make it a bit clearer with what we're doing, what we can see. Now we go to features, lofted boss base. In the graphics area, click near the same place on each profile. For example, the upper right side. So the loft path travels in a straight line and does not get twisted. Select the sketches in the order you want to connect them. All right, what this means is if I'm joining all these shapes as a loft and I click on the top of one circle and then the bottom of another and the top of another, you can see how it's kind of getting twisted around as it's moving. That's not ideal. Now you can clean that up manually and you regularly have to, but if you can, it's always best to just select them in the rough order so that contour or that joining point between all of them stays the same. And then for the rectangle at the end, I'm going to click on the side. Now, if you want to line them up properly, what I'd suggest is you go to like a front-on view and you just see if they're lined up. And we can see here, they are all relatively lined up on that 45 degree angle, which is really nice. I do talk a bit more about this in one of my tutorials that I'll be linking around here about now. So the preview shows you how the profiles will be connected. The system connects the points or vertices closest to where you click. Examine the preview of how the profiles are connected. So this is what we see here, the yellow is a preview. We haven't actually created the loft yet. If the sketches appear to be connected in the wrong order, you can use the move up or down buttons under the profile. So what they mean here is in the feature tree or in the profile properties manager, the loft properties manager, you can see the lofts and the order they're selected. You can press these buttons here to move them up or down. Now ours are in the right order, so we're not going to change anything. When we're done and happy, press the tick and that creates the solid body loft. All right, next, create a boss loft. For the pointed end of the hammerhead, you create another loft. Hold down control and drag an edge of the front plane to create an offset plane behind the original front plane. Or you just select the plane, type in 200 and we want to hit flip offset because we want this to go in another direction. Press OK. Make sure that flip offset is selected, as we've said. Click hidden lines removed on the view toolbar. So hidden lines removed. Click normal 2. Now you can, instead of clicking on the standard views toolbar, if you click a plane or a face, you can click normal 2 here on the little shortcut bar that pops up. Open a sketch on plane 4, and we're going to sketch a narrow rectangle as shown. So we'll do a center point sketch again. Don't worry about this business of dimensioning from the middle, okay? If you drop a center point circle on the middle, you can skip that entirely and add in our dimensions, 150 by 5. Okay, next. So we're just going to close that, accept that sketch, hide that plane. Okay, and now we're going to complete the second lofted boss. So we just changed to a 3D view. We're going to open up our loft, click the square profile, and then click corresponding corner on the sketch. So if you click somewhere near the top corner here, and you can see that profile is coming off this point, you want to click on the corresponding point on the next sketch so that the lines join together. If they're twisted, you'll end up with a result like this. Now, if you do get to that point, what you can do is you can click and drag on that connection point and move it between until you get a result that suits what you're looking for. So we've examined the profile, examined the preview of how the two profiles will be connected, and then we click OK. And we change to a shaded view, and then we can see top of our hammer. Next step. Now, bending the part with the... This is where we get a little bit into less controlled elements of SolidWorks. The flex feature here. So the flex feature deforms a model. You can use that flex feature to bend, twist, taper, or stretch a model. Here, you use the flex feature to bend the hammerhead. So we're going to click flex. In the property manager, under flex input, select the part in the graphics area for bodies for flex, which is here, and click the body. And then we're going to select bending. Under trim plane 2, select a reference entity for trim plane 2. And then in the graphics area, select the vertex as shown. So we're going to move trim plane 2, which is this red one, up to this point here. Okay, what that's going to do is limit our bending area to the section at the back. So trim plane 2 aligns with the vertex. Right click the triad center sphere as shown and select align 2. Then expand the flyout feature manager design tree, which is this one here. You can also do that by pressing the C key and select the right plane to align the trim plane axis parallel to the right plane. Okay, I think that is done. Completing the bend. Right click on the triad center sphere. Oh boy, it's getting a little tricky here. So we've done the first step. Select the vertex as shown. Trim 2 plane aligns to the centered vertex. Right click the triad center sphere as shown and select align 2. Okay, I think that's looking okay and looking aligned. Right click the triad center sphere and move triad to plane 2. All right, so we're gonna right click and go move triad to plane 2. You can see it moves it up to that plane, and we drag the pointer over trim plane 1. When the pointer changes to a, drag the pointer over an edge, of trim plane 1. When the pointer changes to a rotate, click and drag the pointer up and down. Only the material between the trim planes moves. Okay, I think we're missing something here. Trim plane 1, click. Oh, fun. Drag the pointer over an edge of trim plane 1, which we've done. When the pointer changes to click and drag the pointer up and down. All right, that's not working. We're gonna hit some numbers instead. So we're controlling it with the dimension in the left. The tutorial here is not very clear about how that's supposed to work by clicking and dragging. Maybe it's that one there. So if I click on that point, that's the triad of trim plane 1. No, it doesn't wanna do it. I don't wanna do that. Oh boy, yeah, it's not good. We're just gonna move it down to a 35 degree and then press enter. And so you can see the flex feature here. So we do have the controlling point for the dimension and we can change that, but otherwise, yeah, it's not great, this tool. And click the tick and we're done. Congratulations, you've completed this tutorial. Oof, oh boy. All right, well, I should stop saying that. So yeah, that's the loft tutorial. This flex feature, look, if I wanted to create this geometry, I'd be doing that with a loft, and I'd be doing it with a loft down here. So I'd do my sketch down here and actually get it to the point up there that I want. I would not be using the flex feature to create this geometry because I just don't have the control that I really want in my models. You can see how that's so kind of freeform here with the dimensions. Yeah, like there are more control points here, but the flex tool, not recommended. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful and found something new to enhance your SolidWorks skills. Don't forget to subscribe to Fully Defined for more tutorials, tips, and insights from a certified SolidWorks expert. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. If you have any questions or topics you'd like me to cover, leave a comment below. I read all comments and love hearing your feedback. Remember, with the right skills and tools, you can turn your design dreams into reality. Keep modeling, keep learning, and always fully defined.